गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो एज वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड अवर चैप्टर नंबर वन एक्सरसाइजेस आई विल प्रोवाइड यू लेटर ऑन. सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द चैप्टर टू कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ फूड ऑफ अवर क्लास सिक्स साइंस. सो बिफोर गोइंग ऑन कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ फूड लेट अस फर्स्ट रिकॉल व्हाट इज अ फूड. So food is a substance that can be broken down into simpler substance to provide us energy. Now food contain nutrients. So nutrients are the substance that are needed by our body for healthy growth and functioning. What again? Nutrients are the substance that are needed by our body for healthy growth and functioning. For our daily to daily works like breathing, running, jumping, etc. The food that we eat consists of different nutrients and or components. There are five major components of our food. Let us see one by one. Carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Again, carbohydrate, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Other than that, there are two essential nutrients that are required by our body, dietary fiber and water. This component together keeps the body healthy and helps for the better functioning of our day-to-day works. Now one by one we will look at each component of our food. First of all, as we have seen, it is carbohydrates. So carbohydrates are the essential nutrients of our body. What does they do? They provide us the energy needed to work throughout the day. So what are carbohydrates? Carbohydrates are the essential nutrients of our body. They provide us energy to perform our daily to daily work. Carbohydrate provide us energy needed to work throughout the day. There are two types of carbohydrate, starch and sugar. Starch and sugar are the two main types of carbohydrate found in our food. First of all, we will see about sugar. So sugar is found in our table sugar, that is our sugar which is used at our home. It is also found in fruits, honey, and some of the sources of sugar. Milk contains a type of sugar that is called lactose. So where the sugar is found? Sugar is found in table sugar, fruit and honey. Milk contains a type of sugar that is called a lactose. Now next, starch. Green, I think so we have studied in the previous chapter. So green plant make their food in the form of sugar. Extra sugar is converted into starch in plant. Rice, wheat, corn, potatoes are some of sources of the starch. When we eat starch containing plant products, our body break this starch into glucose, which is utilized by the body. So what happens to the food in our body when we eat food like rice, wheat, corns? So these contains starch. This starch is converted into glucose. This glucose is utilized by our body, which is used by our body for functioning of the daily to daily works. Some examples of the starch are wheat, bread, corn, potatoes, etc. Now we will look at the second essential nutrient of our body, that is fat. What is a fat? Fat is a nutrition that keeps our body warm and also provide us energy. What is a fat? Fat is a type of nutrition that keep our body warm and provide us energy. Now there are two types of fat. One is mostly solid at room temperature, that is butter, and one is liquid at room temperature, that is vegetable oil. So there are two types of fat which are solid at room temperature, that are example is butter, and other type of fat which is liquid at room temperature is a vegetable oil. Oil, ghee, nuts, butter, cream, cheese are some sources of fat. Fat are also present in milk, fish, meat and eggs. So the sources of fats are oil, ghee, butter, cream, milk, fish and eggs. What does now the fats do? Fat give us more energy than the carbohydrate. So fats give more energy than the carbohydrate. A limited amount of fat is, but only limited amount of fat is important in the diet for healthy functioning of the body. If we are taking the food, then we need only a limited amount of fat. What happens if we take excess amount of fat? If we start eating too much amount of fat, it can be harmful, because excess amount of fat is consumed and is stored in the cell called the fat cells in the body, and over a time this condition leads to a obesity. This condition leads to a obesity, that is a excessive and harmful fat deposition in our body, that we also said that body has become fat. So why it is called why the body becomes fat? Because when the extra amount of fat is stored in the cells, that are called fat cells, these lead to a condition which is called as a obesity. Which this obesity result into the many diseases like heart disease, blood pressure and etc. Junk food such as sweet chips, fries and burgers etc. are harmful because they are poor in their nutrient content, but they have high amounts of fat and sugar. So aerated drinks and fat burgers, they consist a high amount of fat and less amount of nutrition value. Got this? Now we will look at our another nutrition, important nutrient that is required our body by our body, that is protein. What is a protein? Protein is a kind of a nutrition which is required by our muscles, organs and even blood. These all are made up of proteins along with other things. Our body need protein for muscle building and repairing of the tissue. Why do we our body require protein? Our body require protein for muscle building and repairing of the worn out tissue. If we do not eat the required amount of body, our body will not be able to repair damaged cell. Suppose if we get fell down, so what is the essential nutrition it will be required by our body? Or if our bone is broken, what is the nutrition required by our body? So it is protein. Protein helps in the muscle building and repairing of the worn out tissue and repairing of the damaged cell. It helps to repair the damaged cell and help to build the new ones. Rich sources of animal protein are meat, fish, eggs and milk. Rich source of plant protein are pulses. See, you can see in the diagram. Rich sources of animal protein are chicken, milk, eggs, fish, and rich sources of plant protein are pulses, green peas, soya beans, chickpea and groundnut. These are all sources of protein. These are the animal sources of protein and this is are the plant source of protein. Next we will talk about another essential nutrition, that is a vitamin. Our body needs vitamin and mineral for its normal functioning and prevention from diseases. What does the vitamin do? Vitamin helps in the normal functioning of our body, and also it protect us from various diseases by developing or enhancing the immune system of our body. Vitamin helps in keeping our eyes, bones, teeth and gums healthy. Vitamin are of two types, fat soluble and water soluble. There are two types of vitamins. One is a fat soluble vitamin and another is a water soluble vitamin. So what are the fat soluble vitamins? Vitamins such as vitamin A, vitamin D and vitamin E and vitamin K. Vitamin A, D, E and K are the fat soluble vitamin, as these vitamins are stored in the fat tissue of the body and used when the body needs them. So these are stored in the fat tissues of the body and can be used when the body needs them. Vitamin D is also prepared by our body in the presence of sunlight. So these are stored in the fats in our body and require and can be used when the body needs them. And vitamin D is prepared by the body when it is in the presence of sunlight. Next, water soluble vitamins. Vitamin C and vitamin B complex, a group of vitamin B1, B2, B3, B5 and B12 and folic acid. These vitamin C and vitamin B complex are water soluble vitamins. Water soluble vitamin cannot be stored in the body and therefore need to be regular supplied through the food. So what is the difference between a fat soluble and water soluble? Fat soluble vitamins can be stored in the body, but water soluble cannot be stored in the body. They have to be taken through the different sources. Lack of vitamin in the body affects the functioning of the body organs and causes deficiency diseases. Lack of vitamin in the body affects the functioning of the body organs and causes the deficiency of the diseases. Some rich sources of the vitamins are eggs, lemons, spinach, carrot, fish, milk, radish, many and green leafy vegetable. These all are the sources of vitamins. So what does the vitamin do? Vitamin helps in the proper functioning and preventioning of the diseases by developing the immune system in our body.